Hello everyone, I know it has been a while since my last tutorial. I'm pretty sure it's been like around 7 months, I don't know. I don't actually know. But, well, here we are, making our tutorial. So I don't really know what to make for a tutorial, so I'm gonna leave that up to you guys for the next video. So, since I don't really know what to do, I'm going to just be doing something simple. You'll be able to request what I should do next in the description. I'll put a form there. I'll read it, check it every so few weeks. But today we're going to be making a simple player whitelist. Now, not for those like exploit ones I've seen on YouTube, because you know I was just checking YouTube to see if this was actually there, and I just noticed that not a lot of these are there, and I wonder if people, you know, want games only for their friends, like they want it to be public, and I guess they don't know how to use the permission system on Roblox, but like they want it to have like where when specific people join, nothing happens, but like when a person that you don't want joins, they get kicked, or a random person, or like, you know, like a door where you touch it and it'll open if it's the owner or your friend, so it's like a secret door, or if you click it. So that's what we're basically be doing. We're going to be making the whitelist script. So it's pretty simple. I'll have a link in the description if you don't want to watch this part of the video. So if you really just want to, just look in the description. There'll be directions on what to do with it. Or you could just watch the video and have the copy and paste ready. So first we're just going to do like the actual whitelist system itself. So just insert a script. What we're going to do is we're going to make a table. The table will be storing the usernames. Which we will be using, so we'll do local usernames equals this. So this is a regular local thing, so you don't really want it to just be quotation marks. You want to do the brackets. It should be under the equal key. Hold shift and press that, then click enter, and you should get that. So okay, let's go type my username. No, you're going too fast. What you want to do now is do those quotation marks. I think they're called quotation marks. So once you've done that, go ahead and add your username. Wow, that's pretty cool. I want to add more. Oh no, I'm getting an error. Okay, so the reason why is because you need a comma, and then you can do it. But I like having my script look clean, so I prefer to press enter, and then put the quotation marks, and then put my next username. So that's basically all you need to do for multiple usernames. So just do what you want there, do a comma, enter, more quotation marks, blah 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 blah, you get the point. So now that we have our username, we're going to want to do the actual thing. So for a server script, this is what you're going to need to do to get the player. So what we're going to do is game.players.player added called connect function. Let's not do that. Function, and what you want to put in here is basically anything, really. Anything that you can understand. And I just noticed I deleted something that I shouldn't have. There we go. Okay. Yeah, just I deleted something there. Don't worry about that. So in this function area right here, you basically want to put anything here. This will define the player, so it doesn't really matter. You can put PLR, player, anything that you would remember. So for me, just for like easy, I don't know, tutorial, I'll just do PLR. Once you've done PLR, you can now do the actual checking thing. So just do for I the in pairs, and then in these whatever they're called, you want to put usernames. Not user settings, user names. What you put in here basically is your table name. So local, whatever this is, and then your stuff should be there. But you want to make sure you put this into here, and then do, press enter. Now, what does this do? Well, game.players, this will get the player. So for IV in pairs, this is basically for tables. For I, it is the number definition of the table. So basically, I is 1. And then V is basically what the actual table is holding. So V is my name. So if I were to have multiple things, such as the, if I were to do I would be 1, 2. V would be Thomas, and then the. That's basically what it is. We're not going to be using I for today. We're going to be using V because it's what the table contains. So what you want to do now is use an if statement. So if V double equals, because we're checking, double equals usernames, not user settings, usernames, then, congrats, you have the whitelist. So we're just going to do a simple print, yay. And I just noticed I did this wrong. So you don't actually want to do usernames, because that would just always print yes. You want to do plr.name. Now you want to add dot name with a capital N, because we're going to be checking by name. If you just do plr, nothing's going to happen. Now, this isn't really that secure. You can use user IDs if you figure that out, but we're just going to be using usernames just to keep this simple. Because I'm pretty sure exploiters can somehow change their name, and you know. But we're just going to do this simple thing, and if we look in the console, it should print yay. As you can see, it is printed yay in the console. So now that we've done that, okay, so now, does this work if the username is not in the table? So that's what we're going to be testing. So I'm going to remove a number from my name. Now it should not print yay. Look at that, no longer printing yay. So, let's say you wanted to kick someone out. All you'd have to do then is plr:kick. Not allowed. I'm pretty sure that's how this works. Okay, so I kind of did that wrong. So, if you want this to be a whitelist actually, this could actually be a blacklist. This is basically a blacklist right here. So if you want it to be a whitelist, then do, well, nothing. So I usually put void when nothing happens, so I don't get confused. So then you want to do else if, or if you just want it to be easy, just do else. And then that's when you do plr:kick, blacklisted. So you saw what happened when my name was here. So let's go ahead and remove my name so that we can actually test if the kick works. As you can see, I just got kicked. And if I put my name back to normal, I will not get kicked. Yeah, that's basically it. So, now that you know that, go ahead and use this. I'll have the regular version, the regular whitelist system. It looks like this. It's just this. I'll also have the blacklist one I just demonstrated. So I'll have both of those. Make sure you choose a select one. Make sure you just choose one. If you need any help, I will do my best to help you. I usually respond within like 3 days when the video first goes up. But like after like 1 week from the video has gone up, it'll take me about a week to respond to your comment. 2 days if you get lucky. But anyways, that should be it. And I'm glad to be doing Roblox tutorials again instead of just random Beat Saber content. So anyways, now that we're done with that, you can use this to your liking, whatever you need to, blah blah blah. Anyways, see you next time.